Today we are looking at ratios. Now we have to see how we can create a ratio. Now for instance, we are given different shapes here. You can see we have circles, we have triangles, we have squares, and we have a star. Now, we can create a shape, we can create a ratio, triangles to circles. Now let's look at triangles. We have 1, 2, and the circles we have 1, 2, 3. That means the ratio triangle to circles will be 2 to 3. Now when you look at the squares, two triangles, we have 4 squares and we have 2 triangles. That means 4:2, which you can simplify it to 2:1. Next is the star to circles. We have 1 star, we have 3 circles. That means 1:3. Here we have square to all shapes. If you check, we have 4 squares and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 other shapes. If we simplify, we shall get 2:5. Now that's an example of how we can create a simple ratio. Now let's see how do we simplify a ratio. Now always we know ratio is a portion, and we can change this portion into a fraction. Then we can simplify by 3, we get 1, by 3 we get 2, taking it back to 1:2. Same to 15:6, by 3, 5, by 3, 2, giving us 5:2 as the simplest. 16:20, by 4, we get 4, by 4, we get 5, meaning 4:5. Now, here, definitely, we shall have 45,000/900. 2 zeros we simplify. By 9, 5, by 9, 1, meaning 50:1. Now that's how we can simplify a ratio. Now, write an equivalent ratio to the given ratio. What is an equivalent ratio? This is a ratio which has exactly the same value as the given ratio. And all the equivalent ratios, if I have a simplified ratio, equivalent ratios will be the multiples of these. 2:14 is an equivalent ratio to 1:7. 3:21 is also another equivalent ratio. 4:28 is another equivalent ratio. So we can have so many other equivalent ratios. Now when you look at this ratio, it's not the simplest. Now, by simplifying it, we shall get 1:8. 1:8 is an equivalent of 3:24. Even if we choose to double this, by times 2, 6, times 2, 48. This also is another equivalent ratio to this ratio. 3:1. It could be 6:2. This ratio is equivalent to this one. It could be 3:9. So 9:3 is also equivalent to this one. So they can continue. This means in the section of the equivalent ratios, we can have so many other ratios. Last one here, we have 2:8. We can have 3:12. We can have 4:16, and so on and so forth. That is about equivalent ratios. Another situation. Write given ratio to the form One ratio n. Now, what do you mean when you have n? This means let the first ratio to be 1, then whatever will remain will represent the side of n, meaning n will be any value that will remain after making the first ratio 1. How do you make the first ratio 1? By getting that ratio and divide it by itself on both sides. Now 1, 2 divided by 2, we shall get 1. Now clearly one side is now 1. The other side will be 10 divided by 2, giving us 5. The second example here, divide by 3. Now, this side we shall have 1, the other side it will remain a fraction. That is 5 over 3, and we could write it 1, 2 over 3. In the last one, 12 ratio 4, we can divide 12 both sides, and this side will be 1, the other side we simplify it and it will be 1 over 3. Now here, we have written this to the form 1 ratio n, where n will be any value remaining after making the other side 1. Let's look at another. In this case now, any value this side, 1 the other side. This means if I have ratio 1 to 2, on the side of 2, I have to make it 1. Meaning 1 the other side, this side it will remain a fraction. So, half ratio 1. In the second example, we shall divide 10. Because we want the other side to have ratio 1. So, 10 divided by 10, I'll get 1. 5 divided by 10, I'll get a half. On the last example here, again, I will divide by 4. Why? Because this side, I want a ratio of 1. Now, the other side will be 20 divided by 4, giving me 5. Now, let's get a portion. When you want to divide the ratio, to change the value into two parts, it's like I'm portioning the ratios. I have to first get the total ratio, that is 3 plus 1, 4. Meaning, the first portion will be 3 over 4 times the available amount. This will give me 1, this is 100, meaning 300, comma, that's the first value. And the other value will remain 1 over 4 times 400, giving me 100. What have I done? I have divided this into this ratio. So I'll have these pounds and those pounds. The same situation here. The total ratio will be 10. Meaning, the first portion will be 7 over 10. Times 1,500, giving me 7 times 1,500, and I simplify one zero and remain with 150. So 150 times 7 to give me 1,050. And the other 3 over 7 times 1,500 will give me 450 of the dollars. So that was division of the ratio. And dividing the ratio is getting portion of the ratio. Now here, finding the missing value in the ratio. We are told that this ratio is supposed to be exactly as that ratio. In other words, this is equivalent. But let's see, what is the value of x? We can change this into a fraction, then cosine pi. 6 times 8, I get 48, is equal to x times 24 is 24x. Divide by 24, divide by 24. Clearly, the value of x is 2. In the same way, I'll do the next example. first multiply, I get 24x, 20 times 5, I get 100. Divide by 24, divide by 24. So 100 divide by 24, it will give me 4 1/6. Now that is finding the missing value. When I have two equivalent ratios. Now what if I get a simple word problem? I can call it a logical portioning of ratios. Saeed and Mary share money in this ratio. If Saeed gets this much, how much did Mary get? Simple, we have Saeed and we have Mary. The ratio of Saeed is 2, the ratio of Mary 3. If Saeed gets 1,700, then how much did Mary get? We shall cross multiply. 2x is equal to 1,700 times 3, giving me 5,100. Divide by 2, I will get 2,550. This is the portion that will be for Mary. Last but not least, a truck carries mangoes, oranges and apples. So for mango I have ratio 1, for orange I have ratio 2, and for apple I have ratio 3. If orange were 100, orange are 100, find the number of purple fruits. Okay, purple fruits will represent the purple ratio. So if orange the ratio is 2, giving us 100 fruits, my total ratio is 6, meaning the total ratio is 6 will be how many fruits? Again, I will cross multiply. 2x will be equal to 600, divide by 2, divide by 2. Then my total fruits will be 300. Now, this was our introduction to ratios. If you enjoyed, you can subscribe to my channel. Thank you.